poor girl through hell of my own insecurities.
Cassie filed a restraining order against you. You went off the rails.
I was starting to hurt other people outside of just myself.
Cassie Randolph weighs in on ex-boyfriend Colton Underwood new Netflix docu-series. Hey guys, and welcome back to another Shared News. We've got all you need to know on how Cassie feels about getting dragged in once again with Colton. But before we get into it, make sure you guys are subscribed to our channel and ring that bell so you never miss out on any future videos, especially around this time of year when the tea is just so piping hot. As always, I am your host, Zachary Reality, and Cassie is not too thrilled, shocker, about being pulled in once again to her ex-boyfriend, Colton Underwood. We all know by now they left The Bachelor together hand in hand as they dated for over 2 years after the show. However, when they split up, the relationship became extremely volatile as Colton put a tracking device in her car and stalked her to the point where she had to file a restraining order against him. Months later, Colton came out of the closet as gay on Good Morning America, and Cassie got looped back in once again to the headlines when their relationship got brought up again as Colton publicly apologized for his wrongdoings to Cassie. During that time, Cassie took the news to her YouTube channel where she says,
"Before I get into anything, I just wanted to say thank you so much for all the kind comments and messages from you guys. I really appreciate it. Regarding the topic in the media that brought my name up this week, just wanted to let you know that I'm not going to be further discussing it or commenting on it for now.
There's a lot of layers to it, and I just think the best thing for me at this time is to move forward and just focus on going forward. I loved her response. I do feel like she has the right to speak up and share her side of the story. I also think she would get a lot of clicks for that too, but I also understand that she doesn't want to feed that fire or get involved in that attention because it was a traumatic time for her. It wasn't just another breakup. This was serious, serious wrongdoings that Colton did to her, and she does not want to be part of that. She does not want her name attached to it. And now that the trailer has dropped for Colton's docu-series, we are less than a week away before the 6-episode Netflix special comes out. Cassie, for the third time, has to deal with the media attention surrounded by her and her breakup from ex Colton, who seems to love the spotlight. Colton cannot get away from the spotlight. No matter how hard he tries, he definitely wants to be in there. So Cassie, on the other hand, isn't in favor of all the attention, especially if it's negative and it's around Colton, and she's really eager to move forward in a positive and productive way. Cassie's going to grad school. She just got a house in Huntington Beach. She has a new boyfriend. She is just really trying to move on with her life here, and her ex Colton is just not making it easy. An insider told Page Six that there are a lot of bad memories associated with the end of their relationship, and she wishes there was a way to completely separate herself from his narrative. The insider continues, "It's nice to see that he appears genuinely sorry, and it's comforting to know that his friends and family are holding him accountable for everything he did to Cassie. You will see in the Netflix series that his dad, a former friend of Colton's and friend of Cassie's, will be in the docuseries as well. He is getting held to the ringer and held accountable for what he did to Cassie."
I put a poor girl through hell of my own insecurities.
Cassie filed a restraining order against you. You went off the rails.
I was starting to hurt other people outside of just myself.
But a lot of fans are wondering, is it enough? He still is getting rewarded with a Netflix docuseries where he's probably cashing in on a big check to kind of, yes, discuss his story about him coming out of the closet, but also at Cassie's expense, because there's no way in sharing his story without mentioning Cassie, because it really is a huge part of what ultimately led him to coming out of the closet was their breakup, and what he did to Cassie and that whole situation was the final straw for Colton, where he could no longer prove that he was straight. An insider also reveals that she wasn't too pleased to see former fellow contestant Onyeka in the Netflix series, as she was a friend to Cassie at one point. The collective attitude amongst the girls of season 23 is that they are happy for Colton that he is out of the closet and free, but they are not happy what he did to Cassie, and they will support Cassie to the end. And seeing Onyeka in this Netflix series is kind of a slap in the face to Cassie. I kind of feel like the reason we're seeing Onyeka because I did see some comments that were like, why is Onyeka there? It's kind of random. I think Onyeka might have been the only person that was willing to do it. They probably reached out to a few girls from Colton's season, and Onyeka is, you know, a reality TV personality. She's fabulous. She's awesome. I loved watching her on Paradise, but she probably was the only person that was willing to do this Netflix series because a lot of the other girls probably didn't want to be associated with it, especially because they are friends with Cassie. And there is a concern amongst Bachelor Nation on how Colton's show is going to make her feel. They want to make sure that she feels supported and that he truly is held accountable and that the Netflix docuseries does not make her look bad or draw any more attention to her. Once this series comes out, we're probably going to be talking again about Cassie and Colton because he is going to be revealing his side of the story and just like more on what he did to her and how he's holding himself accountable and like the reasons why he did what he did. So she's going to be brought up back again for the next few weeks, and she's just not looking forward to it, and neither are her friends from Bachelor Nation. However, Cassie is ultimately happy that Colton is finally at peace with himself and that he could help other, you know, people in the LGBTQIA plus family, you know, with his story, and that he could inspire people in that way. But she wishes ultimately that there was a way for him to do that without mentioning her name and bringing her into it. And unfortunately, if there's going to be a Netflix docuseries, there just isn't a way Cassie's name cannot be mentioned. Like I said, there is 6 episodes, so hopefully the Cassie parts are not in all 6 episodes. Maybe they're just in 1 or 2. It's definitely going to be brought up, and it's going to be hard for her to relive. I don't know if she's going to be watching it. I probably recommend her not to watch it and maybe just have some of her friends watch it and kind of monitor it for her so she knows what's out there, but also so that she doesn't get triggered by any past emotions, because it was a traumatic time. So my heart definitely goes out to Cassie. I am looking forward to hearing Colton's story, and I want to know how he's going to inspire people. And I'm curious, you know, as the first gay bachelor, what his story is like, but not at Cassie's expense. And I really do believe that Cassie should be getting a paycheck from this docuseries, because if she's going to be brought up in this and their, you know, breakup is going to be brought up from The Bachelor, then Cassie should be getting a check. And maybe she is, or maybe she got one, you know, when she dropped the restraining order a year back, or it might have been almost 2 years now. But even another check for Cassie wouldn't hurt, because she did just get that new house in Huntington Beach. So, you know, it could really help her as she's finishing school as well. Cassie's super happy in her life right now. As I mentioned, she has a YouTube channel, she has a new boyfriend, Brighton, and she is just happy and relieved to be living her life drama-free. So it really is just annoying for her and upsetting that this has to be brought up once again. But that is everything I have to share with you guys today. So let us know in the comments, do you guys think Cassie is or should be getting a paycheck from this docuseries? And if so, how much? Because she definitely deserves something for all of this media attention being brought up for the 3rd time about her, just because Colton wants to stay in the spotlight. She does not want to stay in the spotlight. Let us know what you guys think in the comments down below, and make sure you're subscribed to our channel so you never miss out on any future Bachelor tea. As always, I am your host, Zachary Reality. You guys can follow me down below at Zachary Reality and talk all things Bachelor, Bachelorette, Bachelor in Paradise with me. Thank you guys for watching. That is all we have, and we will see you next time. See you later. Bye.